Hello everyone, I hope all of you are doing well in this lockdown. Today I will be giving you a lesson, class 11th snapshot, the address, which has been narrated and even written by Margo Minko. She is a very good writer. She gives here an account of chaos, which is actually, observed during the war. And even one can feel the pain, grief and mental torture the survivors of the war had to go through. So my dear students, I'll be telling you about the summary of this, the address. I tell you here the story. Just hold a minute. Let me adjust my mic. So I tell you here, the address begins with a victim of war going back to her native place. It is about a daughter who returns to her home in Holland. She goes there to search for her mother's belonging after the war. Actually, her family was a Jew family, and you all know during the Hitler time, at the Germany, when fought the war, then it began to hit the Jews, as there was a belief that Jews were the killers of the Christ. So that's why all the Christians people were hating to the Jews. And the Margo Minko tells her that narrator's family belonging to the Jews. When she reaches her native place, that is in the Holland, she does not receive a warm welcome. She follows the address she has on her memory, remembering. It is the house number of 46 in Marconi Street. Marconi Street, a woman opens the door and refuses to recognize the girl on the poor. The author notices that the woman wearing her mother's green knitted sweater. Thus, she became even surer that she was in the right place. However, the woman did not deny not knowing her mother. So my dear students, you must be knowing that the narrator was absolutely knowing about the address. She reached at the perfect house, and despite the author's resistance, the woman did not entertain her and closed the door on her. Do you know what is the reason? You will come to know the reason when you will go through the chapter. Actually, she did not want to return all the belongings which she used to receive from the narrator's mother. And these all pots and utensils were very, very, precious, and gold and silver metallic, materials was there. The author was going back when she starts thinking about the bygone days, means that past days. He obviously say, let the bygone be gone. So when she thought about the bygone days, bygones means here the past days, she got the address from her mother years ago, and after returning to her honest, home post-war, she notices a lot of things missing from the place. Thus her mother gives her an address of Mrs. Darling. And this was the house of Mrs. Darling where she reached. She learns that Mrs. Darling is an old acquaintance. Acquaintance means here that is, the familiar one whom we know from the very beginning, since very beginning we know someone, that is called acquaintance. So she was an old lady, an acquaintance of her mother. So thus her mother handed over all their valuable, you know, possessions to Mrs. Darling to keep them safe. Thus, after many years, the author thinks of going back to take them possessions. Thus, after possessions means all the belongings which she had, which she took from the narrator's mother, you know. Then she went back, she goes back to get all these belongings from the Mrs. Darling, but Mrs. Darling, you know, denies to identify, denies to recognize even the narrator or the author, you can say. Many years the author thinks of going back to take them possessions. Thus, after being told to go away from, you know, by Mrs. Darling on her visit, see, she goes back once again, ek baar phir jaati hai. On her second visit, 15-year-old girl, you know, opens the door and she welcomes, because she could not understand who is she. So she welcomes, and the mother was not at home at that time. Author told her about her wish to meet her mother. The girl takes her in the house, and the author's surprise, she notices that the room full of things her mother possessed, and whatever she used to had in the childhood, and that was lying in the room of that Mrs. Darling's house. And these all, you know, things were similar but not in a good condition. You know, she started to feel uncomfortable to see all these things, and now she had no desire to get back all these, you know, things from Mrs. Darling. And so she left the home and thought of, you know, forgetting the address which she used to remember since her childhood, that she would go back one day and she will meet and she will take the belonging. And she was very disappointed. So I would like to tell you the conclusion of this chapter. The address, in this we learn that intricate emotions of humans like trust, hope and betrayal, and as well as the ill effect of the war. War, any war, either first war or second war, you would have noted down, they all have affected too much the lives of the, even the victors, triumph ones, and the defeated one, all suffer. And the Jews suffered too much in that world war. So this is the lesson, and this is the summary. I hope you understood better. Rest I will solve your queries later on. Thank you.